की श्री हरिदास ठाकुर की श्री बकुल धाम की। पतित पावन श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु की, श्री क्षेत्र जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की, नेताय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि ओम अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य स्लोली पीसफुली ओम अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकाय चक्षुषुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मायं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुता पदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथं वितन्तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान् सहगणलित श्रीविशाखान्वितंश्च हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबन्धु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिकाकांत राधाकांत नमस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वंशकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नम ओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामीति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा। So we at the Bhajan Kutir of Sri Namacharya Haridas Thakur. Sri Namacharya Haridas Thakur ki! It's one of the very special places for a devotee to gain maximum of this yatra is to contemplate on the life of Srila Haridas Thakur. It is so deep and so much absorbing. When I was reading so many pastimes, practically Srila Haridas Thakur actually witnessed almost all the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Sankirtan mission. Because when Mahaprabhu, he began the Sankirtan mission, Srila Haridas Thakur, he was there already in Navadvip. We know he was praying along with Advaita Acharya. So practically he witnessed the whole Navadvip pastime. And when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu from Navadvip, he decided to come and reside here in Jagannath Puri, Haridas Thakur also came here and resided here, right at this place. So we all know from the Krishna Leela, one day Lord Brahma had a doubt. He had a doubt that how can Krishna be the Supreme Personality of Godhead and how can he do all these miraculous activities? I think this was exactly after killing Agasur. You know, after killing Agasur, all that Brahma got a little late, the pastime says. Brahma got a little late and he saw such a big snake and the little boy Krishna killed. He said, how is it possible? How is it possible? So Brahmaji, he actually stole all the calves, you know, and all the cowherd boys, and he kept them hidden in a cave. The cave is still there in Vrindavan. Actually, I'm sorry, that's Vyomasura's cave. Brahma's cave is also there at some place. So after stealing and hiding the children and the calves, Lord Brahma for a while just disappeared. And Brahma's disappearance for a while becomes 1 year in the earth planet. You know? So Brahma, when he came back, he saw that Krishna is present in all the houses in the form of the gopas. Because Krishna also thought that, it's getting late now and I have to go back with all my friends and also all the calves. The mother cows and the elderly gopis, they are waiting for their children and the calves. So then Krishna understood and then he expanded himself. And Srila Gopalachampu mentions that that's the when all the Brajagopis were married, maybe child marriage at that time. All the Brajagopis were married to all the boys available in Vrindavan. So in one way they were already married to. And we all know all the calves, cows had such a great desire to feed their milk to Krishna. So when Brahma did this mishta, Krishna took the advantage of fulfilling the desires of his devotees of Vrindavan. And then later on when Brahma realized, oh my God, what a great offense I have done to my Supreme Lord. So he actually begged, and there is whole prayers of Brahma in the Bhagavatam. And then after begging, he requests Lord Krishna that, my Lord, please get me rid of this upadhi. Please get me rid of this position. You know, everyone is suffering with this, you know, ego on their head, and I have four. You know, I have four. I'm suffering with this forehead, and above that I'm the creator. I'm creating everything. My Lord, this has become a very big obstacle in the path of my devotion to you. Please get me rid of this. And he cries to Lord Krishna. At that time it is mentioned in the Bhagavatam that Krishna doesn't speak much. And goes away. But Brahma, he carried the offense in his heart and he did not feel satisfied. And then he went to Navadvip after that. And at Navadvip, he went and sat and was chanting continuously, Gauranga, 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 until and unless Lord appeared to him, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared to him. And then Mahaprabhu told him, this is one of my first stories I ever heard from His Holiness Jayapada Goswami Maharaj when I went to Mayapur in 2003. Right on the same, when I heard this story, the same afternoon, the same morning, after 1 hour, I met Atul Krishnapu first time in my life. Jayapadaka Maharaj was giving a class and he was narrating this pastime, that how Brahma was chanting with his four mouths loudly, Gauranga, Gauranga. Though Mahaprabhu's time was not there, still he appeared there and told Brahma that when I appear in Kali Yuga as Chaitanya, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, you will appear and you will get such a birth that you will not have any pride and you will be the acharya of my that avatar. Because Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appears to give what?
Holy
name. And you will become Namacharya, the acharya of the holy name. In this way, Lord Krishna actually gives benediction. So, Haridas Thakur, after Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, before Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance, many of the acharyas, they already took appear. They appeared in Navadvip and around the whole Bengal. So it is mentioned that Haridas Thakur, Srila Haridas Thakur, he was born in a Muslim family. It is said that he was born in a village called Buron, which is in the district called Kuluna in now it is a part of Bangladesh. And immediately after his birth, he showed all the symptoms of being a pure devotee and started regularly chanting the holy name. It is mentioned, Srila Haridas Thakur used to chant every day 3 lakh rounds, 3 lakh names of Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. In fact, when Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, he starts narrating the pastimes of Srila Haridas Thakur, which is there in Chaitanya Charitamrita, he actually finds it difficult to, how can I glorify Haridas Thakur? And then he actually offers some prayers. We will chant those prayers from Chaitanya Charitamrita, Antya Leela, chapter number 3. Where is Ishan? Can play? Mridanga? Chapter number 3, verse number 93.
तभे महाप्रभु निज भक्त पाशे आया, तब महाप्रभु निज भक्त पाशे आया, हरिदास रघुन कहे शतमुख होया, रघुन शतमुख होया, भक्त रघुन कहे प्रभु रदय उल्लास, भक्त रघुन कहते प्रभु रदय उल्लास, भक्त गण श्रेष्ठ तते श्री हरिदास, भक्त गण श्रेष्ठ तते श्री हरिदास, हरिदास रघुन गान असंख्य अपार, हरिदास रघुन गान असंख्य अपार, केहो को न अंश वर्णे नाही पाय पार, केहो को न अंश वर्णे नाही पाय पार, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
Translation: Then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to his personal devotees and began to speak about Haridas Thakur's transcendental qualities as if he had hundreds of mouths. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu derives great pleasure from glorifying his devotee, and amongst the devotees, Haridas Thakur is the foremost. The transcendental qualities of Haridas Thakur are innumerable and unfathomable. One may describe a portion of them, but to count them it is impossible. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, as I was mentioned, he appeared in now the provision is in Bangladesh, and Mahaprabhu, Haridas Thakur, he was already very famous for regularly chanting the holy name. Right from his birth, he had the qualities of a pure Vaishnava, and everyone nearby had already become devotee of Haridas Thakur by his qualities, by his association, by his pure chanting. And later on, it is said that Haridas Thakur, he moved up to a place very close to Shantipur, which is called Puliya. And at Puliya, Advaita Acharya becomes so excited now that Haridas Thakur has come very close by. And every day they would meet each other and discuss Srimad Bhagavatam and chant the holy name. And in Puliya, Haridas Thakur had already become very famous, and he has built a small cave below a tree. You've been Puliya? And he was chanting there loudly, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. In this way, one day, many devotees used to come and regularly meet Haridas Thakur. But devotees would not stay long, and out of fear they would run away. Because where Haridas Thakur was sitting and chanting, below that cave was a very dangerous snake, poisonous snake living there. So then devotees expressed this out of fear to Haridas Thakur that, my dear Lord, we want to come and meet you, we want to associate with you, but somehow there is this dangerous snake who is residing below your cave, and out of the fear of that snake, we cannot come and seek your darshan, my Lord. When Haridas Thakur came to know about this, because Thakur was always busy in chanting the holy names of the Lord, he never heard anything except loudly chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. You know, just like Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Gundicha margin, in the Gundicha temple clearing before the Rath Yatra, in Chaitanya Charitamrita we discussed, there was no conversation in Gundicha temple. Everything was Hari Hari. If anyone wanted a broom, they would call Hari Hari, the other person would pass the broom. So in this way, Haridas Thakur's life was only discussing about Krishna with devotees and only chanting the holy name loudly. So he did not know. So when he came to know that devotees are getting disturbed, so he called out to the snake. He said, if you are residing there, I request you to leave this place immediately. So the snake did not respond. Then Haridas Thakur spoke loudly, if you are really residing there, then I request you to leave this place immediately, or I will leave this place forever. As soon as the snake heard that Haridas Thakur has tell that he is going to place the he leave the place immediately, immediately the snake came out, paid obeisances to Haridas Thakur in front of everyone, and left the place and went a little far away and resided there. Immediately the snake left that place, came out. Everyone saw that snake paying obeisances to Haridas Thakur and left the place. In this way, Srila Haridas Thakur had already become famous. And it is said that he was born in a Malechi family, Yamana family. He was born in a Muslim family. In a Muslim family. Prabhupada writes that, you know, devotees there sometimes like Lord Hanuman appeared in a Vanara family. Garuda appeared in a birth family. And similarly, Haridas Thakur appeared in a Muslim family, in a Yamana Malechi family. But he was a pure Vaishnava. His fame was spreading, and many of the people, it's very natural, many people become envious of him. So one day in one assembly, Haridas Thakur had gone to a nearby city, and there was an assembly of Brahmanas reciting Shastra. So then they came to know, because Haridas Thakur would avoid public and would avoid, you know, to be recognized, fame and name. But it is described that the body of Haridas Thakur was so effulgent, so beautiful, so shining. It's like Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that even if people were not aware, when Haridas Thakur would pass by, just by his chanting and his effulgence, one would want to know about him. And once one would know about him, he would just like to be around him until he is present in that place. And imagine in an assembly where Vaishnava was sitting and Haridas Thakur sitting there. So one of the Brahmanas, out of curiosity, he told that, you are actually degrading the whole Vaishnava and Brahmana community, because you are allowing, you are chanting the Vedic mantras, you are chanting the holy name so loudly. All these Vedic hymns and mantras are kept for Brahmanas and Vaishnavas to be chanted secretly within their mind. And they were very unhappy that Haridas Thakur is actually loudly chanting the holy name. So when Haridas Thakur heard this, with great humility, he responded. He said, yes, by chanting in the mind, or very slowly, one will deliver himself very quickly. But when you chant loudly, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, you are not only delivering yourself, you are delivering everyone. All the insects, birds and beasts and non-moving animals, trees, plants, everyone who get to hear the holy name, they all get delivered. That is why I answered my question. If you get a plate of food, if you eat for yourself, you can satisfy your belly. But if you share with others and everyone gets a little, what do you think? What is better? He asked those in the assembly. So they all kept quiet. And one of the Brahmanas said, they had no answer. They had no answer for it. And they kept quiet. And then one of them said that, Kali Yuga is such a situation that Malechas and Yamunas will also take up bhakti and they will portray whatever they want and they will do all kind of Malecha activity, being devotee, dressing them in the garb of a devotees. In this way, one of them spoke to Srila Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur, he got up, he paid obeisances and he left the place humbly. He simply left that place and went away from there. And after a while, that Brahmana got leprosy, throat leprosy. And he was suffering because of the offenses towards Haridas Thakur. And then he went and asked forgiveness, Srila Haridas Thakur. So in this way, one more time, when Srila Haridas Thakur was residing in Bengal only, and it is a place called Jessore district. It was also near Pulia. There Haridas Thakur had made his bhajan kutir and he was chanting the holy names. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. And wherever he would go, it is that Haridas Thakur used to run away from places, because wherever he would go, he would become famous. And he didn't want to become famous, so he would leave the place and run away from there and search a new place to do his bhajan. But when he was residing here, the local jamindar, local brahmana, they had become very envious. Very, very envious of Srila Haridas Thakur. So they went and complained to the local Qazi. In those era, the whole, this part of Bengal, Orissa, was by King Purushottam Bey, Pratap Rudra and all other Vaishnav kings. But the province of Bengal was ruled by the Mughals, So the local Brahmanas, out of envy, they went to the local Qazi and told the Qazi that, look, this person is actually a Muslim and he has renounced his religion and taken up Vaishnavism. And now he is polluting everyone to take up Vaishnavism and he needs to be punished for this. My Lord, you take charge of him. Immediately when the Qazi heard, it is very natural that in someone's province, if one is not a devotee, if the king or the ruler or the minister, if they are not devotees, if they are not associating with devotees, the only thing what they are left in this world is to be envious of each other. You know? We see this in the material world. I remember when I was a child, you know, when there used to be results, there used to be a big envy amongst the mothers, you know. Ye hamare bete ka, aapka kitna 57. आपके बेटे कितना है? For some of the mothers hide the result उन्हें बताने का नहीं कि उसको चुपचाप घर पे रहो तुम एक हफ्ता. You know, if the neighbor's child got 75% and this child got 50%, the mother will keep the child and the report home only for 1 week. तू जाइ मत किधर. You know, I have seen this. You know, so in this material world, if you are not a devotee of the Lord, you envy. So as usual, the king, they all become very envious, that, and this Brahman has become envious that how is this person becoming so famous? So they called Srila Haridas Thakur and they requested him first that, see, you are a Yavana, you are a Muslim. You have to give up this and chant, stop the chanting of the holy name and chant, start chanting Kalma from the Quran. Stop chanting the holy name and start chanting the Kalma from the Quran. This is the instruction to you. From this moment, you do this. There is the Qazis, they have one ministers who actually handle on behalf of Qazi. They are called Mulkapatis. Mulakpati. So when they told this to Haridas Thakur, Haridas Thakur told the Qazi that, by the will of the Lord and based on karma, everyone gets a birth in a different religion and different forms. And everyone gets a birth wherein someone takes a birth in a Muslim family and he chants Kalma from the Quran. Someone takes a birth in a Vaishnava family, Hindu family, he chants the Bhagavatam and the holy name. The means of this chanting and this process is to reach that Supreme Lord only. So by some arrangement, some jivas are influenced to give up Hinduism and take up Quran. And some are influenced by to give up Quran and to take up Bhagavatam and Hinduism. But as per their will, they have the desire to approach the Supreme Lord. So am I. So the Qazi to become very angry when all the Mulkapatis who were sitting there, the way Srila Haridas Thakur's, the way he was speaking, the words coming from his mouth was so influential, they were humbled. So one of the Mulkapati called Haridas Thakur and told him, "My Lord, I beg you that just follow your own religion and this whole story will end right then. Please follow your own religion, chant the Kalma and this end this story." You know. But Haridas Thakur, when he heard, of course out of compassion, out of being attracted to Sri Haridas Thakur, he mentions this. But then, Sri Haridas Thakur very firmly says, even if my body is cut into pieces, if it is cut into pieces, I will not give up the chanting of the holy name. I will not give up the chanting of the holy name. So then the Qazi announced, tells the Mulkapatis that what we call Jallad, no? Hunter, those who give the death sentence by. So they beat him in 22 marketplace. You know. Now don't ask me question why 22. There must be 22 markets at that time. Some devotee out of the whole pastime they catch up 22. Prabhuji, a question tha, like, kya? No, 22 marketplace mein kyun marne bola? You can understand where their mind is, you know. Then. So he told that beat him in 22 marketplace and till death or till he accepts, gives up his religion. And they start beating Haridas Thakur. So much so that the whole body of Haridas Thakur was bleeding. And all the devotees, even the Muslims, they were all crying and praying and begging to Haridas Thakur, please, you give up. But Haridas Thakur did not hear anyone. He did not hear anyone. He was continuously chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Continuously he was chanting the holy name. At one point, Jallads who were beating him got very tired. Very tired. And they started requesting him that, "My Lord, we are tired, but nothing is happening to you. And one thing is for sure, if nothing happens to you, the Qazi is going to take up our heads." You know? So then Srila Haridas Thakur, he immediately meditates upon the Supreme Lord, falls down as if a dead person, and the body of Haridas Thakur is taken to the Qazi, where it is examined as if he is dead, and the body was thrown as a useless garbage into the Ganga. And after a while floating on the Ganga, Haridas Thakur again goes to the bank of the river and sits up place and starts chanting Hare Krishna. Immediately the news spreads all over that Haridas is arrived and he's chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Hare Krishna Mahamantra. The Qazi, the Mulkapatis and all others, they go and beg and take shelter of Haridas Thakur and take his blessings. As soon as that spreads around all over the villages, everyone started coming to take darshan of Haridas Thakur and leaves the place and goes away from there also. Srila Haridas Thakur. So in this way, there are so many innumerable pastimes of Srila Haridas Thakur. Same phrase in Puliya, when Haridas Thakur had become famous, there was one local zamindar whose name was, anyone knows? Ramchandra Khan. Now Ramchandra Khan, Brahmanas, actually in this purport only Prabhupada writes that, you know, in Kali Yuga, specifically envious Brahmanas, they are like Rakshasas who will always give pains to the Vaishnavas out of envy. So they actually envy King Ramchandra Khan about Jamindar, about Haridas Thakur. So Ramchandra Khan, he becomes so envious that he wanted to defame Haridas Thakur, defame Vaishnavism, and prove the world that he is just a show bottle devotee and just an external garb of a devotee, internally is a sense gratifier. So planning in this way, Ramchandra Kani calls a prostitute. Prostitutes actually. And he tells them that I will reward you with as much money you want. As much of money you want. But what you have to do is to go and somehow or other make sure Haridas falls to you all and associate with you all. And I will send my soldiers with you. As soon as this is successful, we will capture him and punish him. So for the money, they decide. And one of the prostitutes come forward. And she said that, I will do this task and then you fulfill all my desires. And she gives a list of things what she wants against it. And she goes, she dresses up very beautifully in the night. And she goes to the place where Srila Haridas Thakur was chanting. And Ramchandra Khan, he tells her, I'll send my soldier. But this prostitute, she tells her, no need to send a soldier now. Let me associate with him once, and second time it will be very easy. Don't worry about it. And then she sends. So the prostitute dresses up very nicely and goes in the middle of the night and shows some portion of her body to attract Haridas Thakur. And Sri Haridas Thakur very deeply chanting, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Very deeply absorbed in chanting. And she requests, she first fell at the feet of Haridas Thakur, pays obeisances, and she requests that, my dear sir, please, I am a alone lady and I am in need of a man. Please fulfill my desires. I want to associate with you. So Haridas Thakur was chanting, very busy chanting his own, chanting on his japa. And then he looks at her, he said, actually, I have my rounds left. And once I am done, I will fulfill all your desires. Because I have my rounds left today. So once I am complete, once I complete my rounds, I will fulfill all your desires. So the prostitute must become so happy. Then my God, in one stroke, it has come achieved, you know. I did not believe it will be so easy. So she sat there and Namacharya Haridas Thakur, he was chanting. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Like this he was chanting. Imagine, we are chanting, it is so amazing together. Haridas Thakur chanting loudly, you know. So the first day, whole night he went on chanting. But in the first day, the prostitute only was shaking like that. And she got up the sunrise and she went away. That, oh, Goshai, you did not fulfill my desire today. So tomorrow I'll come back. So Haridas Thakur, with great humility, he actually told her that, ask forgiveness from her. He requested that, I'm so sorry that I could not fulfill your desires. But I assure you that tomorrow, if you come, I will fulfill your desire. So then she goes with great satisfaction. And then Ramchandra Khan asks her, what happened? He said, no, it didn't happen. But he fell into my trap. But she didn't know, she fell into the trap actually. She said, it didn't happen, but he fell into my trap and he will fulfill my desires tomorrow. So now, next day, again, she goes, very well dressed. And Haridas Thakur, she comes and indicates to Haridas Thakur, Haridas Thakur, oh, please sit down here. Today I should be able to make it. I just have few rounds left. And once I am done with my japa, I fulfill all your desires. As usual, Haridas Thakur sits there. The prostitute is sitting right there in front. And Haridas Thakur is absorbed. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Ram, Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. So, by that time, this is the second night. Prostitute, just first night she was only shaking. The second night when Haridas Thakur continues to chant it the whole night, and he started shaking. Hari Hari, Hari Hari, like this, she started chanting also with Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur looked at her and said, oh. But then already sun was up. But second night she was already very influenced. Already transformed by the chanting, by hearing the japa of the pure devotee, Sri Haridas Thakur. Now, Haridas Thakur, with great humility, he says, I'm so sorry. I felt that I will be able to make it today. And tomorrow, I thought that I will be able to make it today and fulfill your desires. But I'm so sorry. But I request you, you come tomorrow. And I assure you that tomorrow, I will fulfill all your desires. But by this, she was already, got a stroke. The stroke, Nam stroke. She already got it from Pure Vaishnava. And the next day when she came, as usual, Sri Haridas Thakur was sitting and chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So then, the third night when she was hearing, she was completely out of her control. And she started chanting with Haridas Thakur. First though she started saying, Hari Hari, Hari Hari, Hari Hari. Completely absorbed in the holy name. Completely out of her own consciousness. She was completely absorbed. And by the time the sun came up and she begged, she fell at the feet of Srila Haridas Thakur and cried and wept and begged and asked forgiveness that, my dear Lord, please forgive me, please forgive me. I had come here for this mission and I was sent by Ramchandra Khan to pollute you, to defame you and to put you in a trouble. But I beg you forgiveness for, please give me your shelter, give me your shelter. Give me your shelter, I want to become your disciple, I want to take your shelter. She keeps on crying, losing her clothes, hands open, begging, like a mad person. Begging. Haridas Thakur tells her, I knew about it very well. I knew about this envious person. I knew about this already. But then because you had already come, how could I reject something? But I had to give, I can only give you what? And then she actually so much cries for shelter. Haridas Thakur tells her, okay, you do one thing. Go home. And whatever is in your possession, distribute that to the brahmanas and come back here. So she goes. She goes and distributes everything what she has. Everything what she has, she distributes to brahmanas, gives away the house to someone, some brahmana, gives away jewelries and saris. Everything what she has, she distributes, shaves her head, wears the sari and goes to Haridas Thakur. And then Haridas Thakur, where he was residing, he gives that bhajan kuti to her and tells her, sit here and do nam jap. Sit here and do nam jap. And then Haridas Thakur leaves from that place. And this prostitute, she becomes very famous, very, very famous chanting there. and many, many devotees come and take darshan of her regularly. Later on, it is when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he meets Haridas Thakur. He actually glorifies Haridas Thakur amongst all the devotees. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu reminds Haridas Thakur that, do you remember when you were being hit by the Mulukpati's soldiers with the hunter? At that moment, my Sudarshan was just up to release and destroy all of them assembled there. But I could not do that. Because when they were beating you, you were constantly praying for their deliverance. When they were beating you, you were constantly praying for their deliverance. You were constantly praying for their deliverance. That is why I could not do anything. And what I did, then I had to take all that beatings on myself. And Mahaprabhu showed his back, where all the scar marks of the hunter were there on Mahaprabhu's back. When Haridas Thakur saw that, he fainted there and then. He fell at the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, fell there and started crying. First of all, he fell unconscious. Seeing Mahaprabhu taking all those beatings, Haridas Thakur fell there unconscious. And then woke up, he was crying. He said, "My Lord, it is very difficult to understand you." Yes. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to Jagannath Puri, the Vaishnavas who joined Chaitanya Mahaprabhu reside here in Puri. Even Haridas Thakur was one of them. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu requested Sri Haridas Thakur to reside here and do Naam Jap. Every day Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after taking darshan of Jagannath, he would come with some Mahaprasadam for Srila Haridas Thakur. And whenever Rupa Goswami and Sanatan Goswami, whenever they came to Puri from Vrindavan, they actually resided here. If you see below the Siddha Bakul, this tree, you saw the deities of Chaitanya, Sanatan and Rupa Goswami. They would not sit here and chant and do their bhajan. Now you see that this name Siddha Bakul is, there's, of course, one very important thing which His Holiness Mahanidhi Maharaj writes in his books, that Srila Haridas Thakur's residence in Jagannath Puri and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going and taking darshan of Lord Jagannath every day and coming to meet Haridas Thakur is an ideal example how a Vaishnava is supposed to live. A Vaishnava is supposed to be very humble, think himself that how fallen I am, look at himself, never be proud, never have pride of his devotion, and always be absorbed in chanting of the holy name, hearing about Krishna, and wait for the Lord to reciprocate. So, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's coming and meeting Haridas Thakur every day is a symbol that we should perform our devotional service in such a way that the Lord will come and see us. Actually, this is the depth of devotion. When you take up Krishna consciousness initially, you see about so many glorious Vaishnavas in the line, and we desire that I want to become one of them initially. But when you come across sadhus and Vaishnavas and Goswamis who are serving the mission, performing devotional so many years, how humble they are, how humble and simple they are, then we realize how far we are. Isn't it true? Then we realize how far we are. And if we realize how close we are, that is the biggest danger. How close we are is the biggest danger. That's the point when you meet an accident. Although you will be put into test. And that is also seen here, right? We heard the story from Bhakti Purushottam Maharaj. Anyone remembers? Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he told Haridas Thakur to sit here and chant the holy name and take the darshan of Sudarshan, and it will be as good as taking darshan of Lord Jagannath. So there is one very beautiful discussion between Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu which we will read from Chaitanya Chaitamrita Antya Leela, chapter number 3, verse number 50. Yes, verse number 49.
Ekadine Prabhu Hari Dasara Milila. Ekadine Prabhu Hari Dasara Milila. Tanhalaya Goshti Kori Tanhare Puchila. Tanhalaya Goshti Kori Tanhare Puchila. Haridas Koli Kale Yavana Para. Haridas Koli Kale Yavana Para. Gro Brahmane Himsa Kori Madhura Chara.
I'll just read few verses, the translations from here. One day Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu met Haridas Thakur as usual, and in the course of discussion he inquired as follows. My dear Thakur Haridas, in this age most of the people are bereft of the Vedic culture and therefore they are called Yavanas. They are concerned only with killing cows and Brahmanical culture. In this way they are all engaged in sinful activities. How are these Yavanas be delivered? To my great unhappiness, I do not see any way. Mahaprabhu is inquiring Haridas Thakur this, you know. Haridas Thakur replies, Nama Tattva here. Haridas Thakur, my dear Lord, I do not be in anxiety. Do not be unhappy to see the condition of the Yavanas in the material existence. Because the Yavanas are accustomed to saying Harama, 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 Lord Ramachandra, they will very easily be delivered by this Nama Bhasa. A devotee is advanced. In advance, ecstatic love exclaim, O my Lord Ramachandra, O my Lord Ramachandra. But the Yavanas are also chant Harama, Harama, Harama. Just see their good fortune. Namacharya Haridas Thakur, the authority on chanting the holy name, said, the chanting of the Lord's holy name to indicate something other than the Lord is an instance of Nam Abhas. Even when the holy name is chanted in this way, its transcendental power is not destroyed. Even a malecha who is being killed by the tusk of a boar, or who cries in distress again and again, Haram, Haram, attains liberation. What then to speak of those who chant the holy name with veneration and faith? Ajamil was a great sinner during his life, but at the time of death, he accidentally called for his youngest son, whose name was Narayan, and attended the lotus. Lord Vishnu came to relieve him from the bonds of Yamraj, the superintendent of death. Word Rama consists of the two syllables Ra and Ma. These are unseparated and are decorated with the loving word Ha, means O. The letters of the holy name, the letters of the holy name have so much spiritual potency that they act even when uttered improperly. If a devotee once utters the holy name of the Lord, or if it penetrates in his mind or enters in his ear with the channel of oral reception, that holy name will certainly deliver him from material bondage. Whether vibrated properly or improperly, with correct or incorrect grammar, or properly joined or vibrated in separate part, O Brahmana, the potency of the holy name is therefore certainly great. However, if one uses the vibration of the holy name for the benefit of material body or material wealth and followers, or under the influence of greed and atheism, in other words, if he utters the name with offenses, such chanting will not produce the desired result very soon. Therefore, one should diligently avoid offenses in chanting holy name of the Lord. Namacharya Haridas Thakur continued, if one offenselessly utters the holy name, even imperfectly, one can be freed from all the result of sinful life. Further, O reservoir of all good qualities, just worship Krishna, the purifier of all purifiers. The most exalted of personalities worshipped by the choice poetry. Worship him with a faithful, unflinching mind, without duplicity and in a higher elevated manner. Thus, worship the Lord whose name is like the sun. For just the slightest appearance of the sun dissipates the darkness of night. So the slightest appearance of the holy name of Krishna can drive away all the darkness of ignorance that arises in the heart due to greatly sinful activity performed in previous life. Even a faith light from the holy name of the Lord can eradicate all reactions of sinful life. While dying, Ajamil chanted holy name of the Lord, intended to call his son Narayan. Nevertheless, he attained the spiritual world. What then to speak of those who chant the holy name with faith and reverence? Because even the finished ray of the effulgence of the Lord's holy name, one can attain liberation. We can see this in all revealed scriptures. The evidence appears in the story of Ajamil in Srimad Bhagavatam. As Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard from Haridas Thakur, the happiness within his heart increased. But as a matter of course, he inquired further. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the Supreme Lord, inaugurator of the Sankirtan movement, Nam Sankirtan. He is inquiring this from Haridas Thakur. And further, when after Haridas Thakur replied, Mahaprabhu is further inquiring. On this earth, there are many living entities, the Lord said, some moving, some not moving. What will happen to trees, plants, insects, and other living entities? How will they be delivered from material bondage? Haridas Thakur replies, my dear Lord, the deliverance of all moving and non-moving living entity takes place only by your mercy. You already granted this mercy and delivered them. You have loudly chanted the Hare Krishna mantra, and everyone moving and non-moving have benefited by hearing this. My Lord, the moving entities who have heard your loud Sankirtan have already been delivered from the bondage of the material world. And after the non-moving living entities like trees hear it, there is an echo. Actually, however, it is not an echo, it is the kirtan of the non-moving living entities, all this, although inconceivable, is possible by your mercy. When the loud chanting of Hare Krishna mantra is performed all over the world by those who follow your footstep, all living entities, moving and non-moving, dance in ecstatic devotional love. My dear Lord, all the incidents that took place while you were going to Vrindavan. Now, Mahaprabhu gets a shock here. My dear Lord, all the incidents that took place while you were going to Vrindavan to the forest known as Jarakhanda have been related to me by your servant Balabhadra Bhattacharya. When your devotee Vasudev Datta submitted the plea at your lotus feet for the deliverance of all living entities, you accepted their request. My dear Lord, you have accepted the form of a devotee just to deliver all the fallen souls of this world. You have preached the loud chanting of Hare Krishna mantra and in this way freed the moving and non-moving living entities from the material bondage. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu replied, if all the living entities, Mahaprabhu, see further, he is further asking more deeper questions, more detailed questions. Okay, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu replied, if all the living entities are liberated, the entire universe will be devoid of the living beings. Haridas Thakur said, my dear Lord, as long as you are situated in the material world, you will send to the spiritual sky all the developed moving and non-moving entities in different species. Then again you will awaken the living entities who are not yet developed and engage them in activities. In this way, all the moving and non-moving living entities will come in existence and the entire universe will be filled as it was previously. Then he quotes the pastime of Lord Ramachandra. Previously, when Lord Rama left this world, he took with him all the living entities of Ayodhya and then he filled the Ayodhya again with the other living entities. My dear Lord, you have set a plan in motion by descending to the material world, but no one can understand how you are acting. Formerly, when Lord Krishna descended in Vrindavan, he freed all the living entities in the universe from the material existence. In the same way, Krishna, the unborn Supreme Personality of God and Master of all Master Majestic Power, delivers all living entities, moving and non-moving. Nothing is astonishing in the activities of the Lord. Although the Supreme Personality of Godhead may be seen, glorified, or remembered with an attitude or envy, he nevertheless awards the most confidential liberation, which is rarely achieved by demigods and demons. What then he be said of those who are already fully engaged in devotional service of the Lord by descending? So then, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then Haridas Thakur told the most important verses, and after this, it is said that after these verses, Mahaprabhu never discussed with Sri Haridas Thakur or asked him any questions on the glories of the Holy Name. Because Haridas Thakur gave this whole description and then in conclusion he said, we will chant these verses together. After I chant, you can chant. Tai che tumi navadipe Kori avatara Tai che tumi navadipe
koi avatara shakala brahmanda jivira kori lo nistara shakala brahmanda jivira kori lo nistara ye kahe chaitanya mahima mora gochara haya ye kahe chaitanya mahima mora gochara haya se janu ka mora punha eta nischaya se janu ka mora punha eta nischaya tumara ye lila maha amrite ra sindhu tumara ye lila maha amrite ra sindhu चरनाए तारा एक बिंदु मोरा मन गोचराए तारा एक बिंदु एता शूनी महाप्रभु राम ने चमत्कार होइला एता शूनी महा चमत्कार होइला मोरा गुदलीला हरिदास की मोने जानिला मोरा गुदलीला की मोने जानिला मने संतोष तन रे कोइलो आलिंगन माने संतोष तले कोरे आलिंगन भाई प्रकाशित सब कोरिलो वर्जन हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा हरे Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Translation. By descending as an incarnation at Navadvip, you just like Krishna have already delivered all the living entity of the universe. One may say that he understands the glories of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He may know whatever he knows, but as far as I am concerned, this is my conclusion. My dear Lord, your pastimes are just like ocean of nectar. And it is not possible for me to conceive how great that ocean is or even understand the drop of it. Hearing all this, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was astonished. These are actually my confidential pastimes, he thought. How could Haridas understand them? Greatly satisfied by the statements of Haridas Thakur, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu embraced him. Outwardly, he, however, avoided further discussion on this matter. For outwardly, it is said, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after this, never came to Haridas Thakur with curiosity, you know. That just like Ramananda Rai and Haridas Thakur, when they were having discussion, Sri Ramacharya were having, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu having discussion at the bank of Godavari. When Mahaprabhu asked the question, so Ramananda Rai said that, "My dear Lord, you are putting the question, making my mouth the answer and relishing it." You are putting a question and making my mouth the answer and you are relishing it. I am only meant for that service. I am doing that service only. So, Haridas Thakur so amazingly told the glories of the holy name and struck Mahaprabhu with this conclusion. And after this, Mahaprabhu never came and discussed about the holy name. Simply gave him darshan, gave him Mahaprasad and went away. So in this way, these beautiful pastimes that took place here in this, you know, Nama Tattva was described here. With we all go out and preach. Golokira Premadana Harinama Sankirtana. So in this way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to every day come and meet. One day, Govinda, the servant of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he actually came to deliver prasadam to Srila Haridas Thakur. And that day, Haridas Thakur was lying down, sick, and he could not get up. And he had not chanted his rounds also, completed his rounds. So Haridas Thakur, he paid obeisances to the Mahaprasad, and since it has come, honored a very little. And he was very sick. So this information went to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Mahaprabhu next day immediately came with Mahaprasadam and asked Haridas, "Haridas, what happened to you? Why are you lying down like this? Are you fine? Are you okay?" Haridas Thakur replied, looking, paying obeisances to the Lord, looking at the eyes. He said, "My body is fine, but there is some problem with my mind and my consciousness, and because of which I am not able to chant my rounds." So he didn't complain about the body pain, you know, though he was sick. But he said, "My there is a problem with my mind, and I'm not able to chant my rounds." Mahaprabhu said, "Haridas, you have come here to deliver the world, and you are already done with the delivering the world with the holy name. Why are you taking so much of pain of chanting regularly so many names? You please take care of your body and relax and just chant as many rounds you can." So Haridas Thakur, he looks at the Lord and he smiles. He smiles at the Lord and requests Dal. He says, "My Lord," that's also very beautiful verses. In the Ante Letlia 11th chapter, we can chant few verses from here also. 11th chapter, verse 31. When Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is requesting Srila Haridas Thakur like this, so Haridas Thakur is looking at the Lord and smiling and folded hands. He is requesting. He says, "Ek vancha hoya mora bahu dina hoite,
ek vancha hoya mora bahu dina hoite,
lila samar vive tumi loya mora chitte,
lila sambhari pe tumi loya mora chitte,
sei lila prabhu mora kabhu na dekhiba,
sei lila prabhu mora kabhu na dekhiba."
अपनार अंग मोरा शरीर परिवा
अपनार आगे मोरा शरीर परिवा
हृदय दारी मु तुमारा कमल चरण
हृदय दारी मु तुमारा कमल चरण
नयन देखी मु तुमारा चंदन वंदन
नयन देखी मु तुमारा
चंद वंदन जीवाय उच्चारी मु तुमारा श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम
जीवाय उच्चारी तुमारा कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम
हे मत मोरा इच्छा छाड़ी मो पराना
हे मत मोरा इच्छा
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम
Then Haridas Thakur looks at Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and he tells them, my Lord, I have one desire. I have had one desire for a very, very, very long time. I think that quite soon, my Lord, you will bring to a closer your pastimes within the material world. I wish that you not show me this closing chapters of your pastimes. Before that time comes, kindly let my body fall down in your presence. I wish to catch your lotus feet upon my heart and see your moon-like face. With my tongue, I shall chant your holy name, Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Shri Krishna Chaitanya. That is my desire. Kindly let me give up my body in this way. So when Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard this, he said, Haridas, I am here in this world only to take your association. Don't speak like this and talk about leaving me. I cannot live with you, Haridas. I am here in this material world to just take your association. Haridas again smiled and looked at the Lord. He said, don't put me into illusion. Don't put me into illusion, my Lord. There are so many great Vaishnavas in this world who are there to assist in your pastimes. There are so many exalted Vaishnavas who are preaching your glories. There are so many Vaishnavas who are residing here to associate with you. My Lord, please fulfill my desire. Don't put me in this illusion. I beg you at your lotus feet. Please don't put me in this illusion. And then he further begs. Then Mahaprabhu, with great dissatisfaction, he says that, it's amazing to hear that Mahaprabhu telling, I'm here in this world to take your association. You can understand the glories of Haridas Thakur by this. And then it was concluded, but not spoken, that Mahaprabhu will fulfill the desire of Srila Haridas Thakur. And next day, after the taking darshan of Lord Jagannath, Mahaprabhu assembles Swami Damodar, Ramananda Rai, Damodar Pandit, and all the Vaishnavas who are residing here, and all with all of them, he comes to see Haridas Thakur here. And Haridas Thakur, actually, if you come there, there are those dioramas there outside on the entrance. Haridas Thakur is lying down sick, And then all the Vaishnavas around there, and Mahaprabhu with great kirtan, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Loud kirtan is going, all the devotees are chanting. It is said Vakreshwar Pandit had also come. Vakreshwar Pandit in the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is one of the greatest dancers. Greatest dancer. And he was, when he would dance, nobody could have their feet on the earth. It will always be like a spring, up only, looking at him dancing. In fact, it is said when Vakreshwar Pandit would start dancing, he would not allow the singers to stop. So when singers would see Vakreshwar start standing, they would run away. Because he had the capacity to dance for 72 hours continuously. And he would get irritated and start beating the singers if they stopped. So Vakreshwar Pandit was dancing. There was jubilation at this place. And Haridas Thakur looked at all the Vaishnavas who were assembled, took their dust and put on his head. And he took the feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He took the feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and put it on his chest. Looking at the eyes of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Haridas Thakur chanted, Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Shri Krishna Chaitanya. Looking at the eyes of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, having his lotus feet on his chest, fulfilling. Mahaprabhu, later on verses, he actually expresses his helpfulness, how he was completely helpless to stop Haridas Thakur. And he was bound to fulfill the desire of Haridas Thakur. And Haridas Thakur left this world. After Haridas Thakur left this world, Mahaprabhu had tears continuously flowing from his body. Mansar Sarup Damodar Goswami instructed Haridas Thakur that we have to perform the final rites for Thakur. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we all know how tall he was when he was seen, beautiful. He took the body of Haridas Thakur on his own hands. And the kirtan was going on with the body of Haridas Thakur. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was dancing in a procession. And then Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu with all the devotees went. How many of you went and took bath in the ocean? Mahaprabhu went with the body of Haridas Thakur, gave his body a dip in the ocean. And then right on the bank of the ocean, if you see the samadhi of Haridas Thakur, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu with a great kirtan position gave samadhi to the transcendental body of Srila Haridas Thakur. And after covering his body, he created the tobe about his samadhi and circumambulated the samadhi of Srila Haridas Thakur. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu declared. Of course, there's a whole description how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after giving samadhi to Srila Haridas Thakur, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu goes and sits there at the Simha Dwar. And he puts his chadar and he begs. He begs for Mahaprasad for the feast, for Mahafeast of Haridas Thakur's departure. And Mahaprabhu collects, Sri Damodar and Ramananda Rai, all the Vaishnavas, they go and collect Jagannath Mahaprasadam. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu performs a very great feast. It is said, what one could eat regularly to that person, 5 times Mahaprasad, Mahaprabhu was feeding that day in his plate. 5 times. 5 times the prasadam to each one of them. And then did Mahafeast. Mahafeast. Very grand feast. And then Mahaprabhu said, from today, this ocean where the transcendental body of Haridas Thakur was dipped has become a Mahatirth. And those who have witnessed the glorious departure of Haridas Thakur, those who have seen the Samadhi process of Haridas Thakur, those who have actually participate in the whole festival taking prasadam of the departure of Haridas Thakur, get eternal residence in the spiritual world, get Krishna Prem. Shri Haridas Thakur ki! In this way, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after celebrating this whole feast, he actually expresses to his devotees. And those verses are the concluding verses of this chapter. This chapter, a very very deep, very sweet. You can understand the position of Srila Haridas Thakur from this amazing verses. It is verse number 94, the same chapter, Ante Leela, 11th chapter, verse number 94.
Kripa kori Krishna mora diya chila sangha. Kripa kori Krishna mora diya chila sangha. Swatantro Krishna ra icha kailo sangha bhanga. Svatantra Krishna ra icha kaila sanga bhanga. Haridase ra icha yabe haila chalite. Haridase ra icha yabe haila chalite. Amara shakati tanre narila rakite. Amara shakati tanre narila rakite. Icha matre kailo nija prana nishkramana. Icha matre kaila nija prana nishkramana. Purve yena suniyache bhishmera marana. Purve yena suniyache bhishmera marana. Haridas achila prithvi rashiro mane. Haridas achila prithvi rashiro mane. Tanavina ratna shunya hoila medine. Tanavina ratna shunya hoila medine. Jaya jaya Haridase Balikor Haridwane. Jaya jaya Haridase Balikor Haridwane. Eta boli Mahaprabhu Nachena apane. Eta boli Mahaprabhu Nachena apane. Sabha gaye jaya 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 Haridasa. Sabha gaye jaya 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 Haridasa. Namira mahimayana korilo prakasha. Namira mahimayana karila prakasha. Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
merciful upon me. Krishna gave me the association of Haridas Thakur. Being independent in his desire, he has now broken that association. When Haridas wanted to leave the material world, it was not within my power to detain him. Simply by his will, Haridas Thakur could give up his life and go away exactly like Bhishma, who previously died simply by his own desire, as we have heard from the Shastras. Haridas Thakur was the crown jewel on the head of this world. Without him, this world is now bereft of this valuable jewel. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told everyone, "Say all glories to Haridas Thakur," and chanted the holy name of Hari. Saying this, he personally began to dance. Everyone began to chant, "All glories to Haridas Thakur." Who revealed the importance of chanting the holy name of the Lord? Sri Haridas Thakur ki
jai.
So you can hear, so beautiful and so nectarian, so deep it is, that Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is begging that Haridas, I cannot live without your association. Haridas Thakur said, forget it, don't put me in illusion, I am leaving. And when Haridas Thakur wants to leave, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling that out of great fortune, Krishna gave me association of Haridas Thakur. Out of great fortune, Krishna gave me Haridas association. And Haridas, by his free will, he broke the association. And when he wanted to leave, it was not in my control to hold him. It was not in my powers to hold him. It was not in my position to hold him. By his own will, he left, just like Bhishma had the desire to leave in front of the Supreme Lord. And then, such a deep philosophy. Haridas Thakur was the crown, is the crown of the planet Earth. And Earth is without its jewelry now, without its crown now. So it is so deep that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is teaching that association of Vaishnavas is everything. It is everything. There is nothing else a human being has to do in this material world. The only duty of a human birth is to be in association of Vaishnavas. That's it. There's nothing else. That is why he's telling that they can fulfill all our desires because the Lord is in their control. Isn't it true? When Haridas Thakur wanted to leave, Mahaprabhu could not do anything. He had to accept it. Similarly, if Guru and Vaishnavas, they want to bless us, the Lord will be bound to bless all of us. That is why the essence is to always be in association of the Vaishnavas. That's the most important teaching here. One is the holy name. Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And when you are in association of Vaishnavas, in the line of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you are actually with the most opulent people. Why? On the earth. Why? Because they are the crown of the earth. They are the beauty of the earth. These are the essence of the teachings of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, specifically at this place, Siddha Bakul, where Haridas Thakur resided and did Naam Jap. So we all should very deeply pray or beg for the mercy so that we can offenselessly chant the holy name. Golokera Prema Nama Harinama Sankirtan. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's external desires was to give this holy name, inaugurate the Sankirtan mission, Naam Sankirtan. To give Jivera Daya, you know. It says, Kali Kale Nama Rupa? No. Kali Kale Nama Rupa Krishna Avatar. नाम बिना कोली काले नाही अर धर्म सर्वशास्त्र कहे ये ही शास्त्रे राम द एसेंस ऑफ ऑल द स्क्रिप्चर्स आर टेलिंग दैट चैंट द होली नेम एंड एसेंस ऑफ ऑल द स्क्रिप्चर्स आल्सो टू चैंट द होली नेम नाम बिना कली काले नाही अर धर्म The chanting of the holy name, there is no other religion. And this is so connected. You have to chant, Kali Yuga Dharma is to chant the holy name of the Lord, and it is not possible without the association of devotees of the Lord. And if you are in association of devotees of the Lord, you always do what?
Chant.
Isn't it true? And to always chant, you have to be in association of
devotees.
This is the essence. And in this way, you know, of course, I forgot to tell one last story that one Chaitanya Mahaprabhu once in the morning, Lord Jagannath is offered a brush. That brush is, you know what? Datun. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after taking darshan, the pujari gave him the datun of Lord Jagannath. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and told, Haridas, look, I got today. And they put it under the earth. Immediately that become a tree. And that tree is a Bakul Datun actually. And this tree which you have right now, the old tree from the time which is planted by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you can see inside that cage there. It's there. And the other tree, two trees have manifested now up. And the local pujaris were telling that the true trees which have manifested, one of them, 1.5 years, back, it left, actually it has dried up now fully. And one local pujari was mentioning that when this had appeared few years ago, it was said that when one of this tree will leave, there will be a disaster in the material world. And 1 year, 1.5 years back this tree left and we know what's going on. So we can pay obeisances and there are actually one beautiful prayers. You want to chant? It's a little. In the beginning of this chapter, before writing about Haridas Thakur, before even writing about Haridas Thakur, Shri Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami begs at the lotus feet of all the Vaishnavas, before even starting. All the Vaishnavas were here, he begs at the lotus feet. We'll chant this verse. Starts from verse number 2. 11th chapter, verse number 2.
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Daya Maya Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Daya Maya Jaya Advaita Priya Nityananda Priya Jaya Jaya Advaita Priya Nityananda Priya Jaya Jaya Srinivasa Shesha Haridasanata Jaya Srinivasheshwara Haridasanata Jagadananda Praneshwara Jaya Kashi Priya Jaya Jagadananda Praneshwara Jaya Rupa Sanatana Raghunatheshwara Jaya Rupa Sanatana Raghunatheshwara Jaya Gaura Deha Krishna स्वयं भगवाना जय गौर देह कृष्णा स्वयं भगवाना कृपा करि देह प्रभु निज पाद दाना कृपा करि देह प्रभु निज पाद दाना जय नित्यानंद चंद्र चैतन्य प्राण जय नित्यानंद चंद्र चैतन्य प्राण कुमार चरण अरविंद भक्ति देह दाना भक्ति देह दाना जय अद्वैत चंद्र जय चैतन्य आर्य जय अद्वैत चंद्र चैतन्य आर्य स्वचरणे भक्ति देह जय अद्वैत आचार्य भक्ति देहा जय गौर भक्त गण गौर यन्द्र प्राण
जय गौर भक्त गण गौर यन्द्र प्राण
सब भक्त मिल गोरे भक्ति देह दाना
भक्ति देह दाना
जय रूप सनातन जीव रघुनाथ रघुनाथ गोपाल जय मोर नाथ
रघुनाथ गोपाल
नरोत्तम
जय मोर नाथ केशव प्रसाद लिखी चैतन्य लीला गुना Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna
Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama
हरिदास ठाकुर की सिद्ध बकुल धाम की हरे कृष्णा थैंक यू वेरी मच आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट नाउ हिज ग्रेस अतुल कृष्ण प्रभु टू ब्लेस अस दिस कीर्तन
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama.
Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare.
Hare Hare.